This morning, we are in the backyard barbecue. It is a perfect day to be outside and to get grilling. So we have brought in two of our favorites, TV Maitre D, Joe Zito, Chef John Granata from Post Office Cafe.
Yeah, isn't that great?
It is great. Yeah.
And we're al fresco, ladies and gentlemen.
It's
going to cost you more, by the way.
Okay. Beer can chicken.
Beer can chicken. A lot of people are making this.
It can sometimes seem a little intimidating, though.
It's a little intimidating.
How do you go about it?
Well, here's the thing. You really got to pay attention to the philosophy of it.
Okay.
All right? The beer can should be half full. Because if you want, if you drink half of it.
Okay, there you go.
Swig half down.
It's 9 o'clock, John. It's 9 o'clock.
Right. Don't throw it away. Right, Joe?
Yeah.
Right.
It's 9 o'clock.
Half of it down. And then you're gonna insert it in the bottom. What I do is I even put some herbs in the beer.
Are you selecting?
This is fresh thyme.
Okay.
Which is also gonna go in the rub. We're gonna rub it down with some garlic, some brown sugar, some fresh thyme, some salt and pepper. And then basically what we're looking at is I like these craft beers that are coming from anywhere locally.
Yeah.
This one's from Maine. And in there we have lemongrass, lemon and lime peel, and kefir lemon leaves.
Perfect complement.
Yeah,
yeah,
there's
just
some
different.
Nice citrus flavors.
So when
it
permeates inside the chicken, it'll also penetrate outside the chicken.
And just for the viewers at home, it is imperative that half of this beer is out of the can. It's not a joke.
Okay.
Otherwise, you're going to have a little bit of an explosion.
Yeah. All right.
It's a very serious matter. And
we don't want that.
Yeah.
And we also mentioned, too, the size of the bird that you should be looking for.
Right. You don't want to use a roaster, because if you use something more than 5-6 pounds, now you get into additional time, maybe into an hour. And then what's going to happen, no matter what temperature you put your grill on, it's not going to be able to handle it, and it's going to end up black on the outside.
Okay.
So you want this to cook slowly and evenly, and also, you know, let's make sure the can is open.
Yeah, which what we just talked about, because it's really, we can't say that enough. We don't want anyone at home injured, and it's not like, you know, we're defusing a bomb, but it's important.
I'm telling you, some of the best chicken you'll ever have.
There you go. We don't want to scare anyone. No. Just make sure if you're going to take on this recipe that you're listening to these guys and you're doing it right. We're going to tell you.
For now, we want to send it back into the backyard barbecue. Michaela is with John and Joe.
Yes, I am. And we have beer can chicken on the menu. This, of course, is a recipe that please pay attention to, because we want you to go about this safely.
Right. Absolutely.
So, your first preparation in this is obviously to find a really good fresh chicken.
Mm-hmm. Right? And a certain size. What do you suggest?
We don't want anything over 5 pounds for this particular recipe, because it'll take too long on the grill, and you have the endangerment of burning it because of the flame. So, I have a mixture here of some brown sugar, and online you can get all the specifics, but it's brown sugar, black pepper, kosher salt, and garlic powder.
Great.
Okay. So.
And we're going to use this as a rub?
Yeah, we're going to liberally rub this guy down. So he's actually having a good morning for a little while. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use some fresh thyme. Fresh thyme. We're going to liberally...
That smells great, doesn't it?
Just the rub alone.
Right.
And now, do you put anything under the skin? I know sometimes when you are applying stuff...
Yeah, well, here's the thing. You don't need to put anything under the skin, because the beer that we're using has herbs in the beer.
And that'll seep through.
And it's going to permeate.
Now, I'm pouring out half the beer, as we talked about.
This is a huge step. This is very, very important. You don't want any explosions when you're cooking this. Please pour out half the beer.
Right.
All right,
Joe,
so we've got it rubbed down.
Joe, there's nothing left.
All right, we are going to tell you what to do after these steps when we come back. We are back outside at our backyard barbecue. We have TV Maitre D, Joe Zito, Chef John Granata from Post Office Cafe.
It's for you.
New spot.
I wanted to be co-host pet.
You know what? I'm going to put it right in my pocket.
No. Maybe next time.
Beer can chicken is on the menu. We've given our chicken a nice little rub down,
a little brown sugar, some olive oil, some brown sugar, some salt, some pepper, some granulated garlic, and some fresh thyme.
Yum.
All right. So we have... a craft beer from Maine. This is Baxter's. I'm not pushing the name in any way, but what I am pushing is the fact of using some of these craft beers that are locally.
An amazing number for the summer, as you know. Just fabulous.
Some really, really cool different ways of processing. Like this has lime and lemon leaves and kaffir lime leaves and
which will pair great with chicken.
Absolutely. And what I'm going to do is we poured out half of this beer, so it's very adamant about, we're adamant about the fact that you want to pour out half the beer, because the full beer, when it comes to a boil, it could explode inside the
chicken. Really important.
We don't want that.
Yeah, you know, we don't have to get into that.
I mean, hilarious, but we don't need
to. Well, yeah, exactly.
Let's be honest. Dangerous.
So half the beer, a little fresh thyme in it, and then what we're going to do is we're going to let them sit on it for a little while.
There you go.
Yeah.
So how long?
Until he's done. So, okay. And I'm going to show you what he looks like when he's done. So it's very, you want to make sure he's stable.
Right.
Yep.
Right? I'm gonna make sure that, you know, play with them a little bit.
What do you want to call it? Setups for these now.
I feel like stands. You should like put a face on the top of it.
So the other thing.
talk about foul play.
Okay.
Thanks very much.
There we go.
Last day.
Okay. From there,
you're gonna go onto the grill.
Now, so you're obviously putting it in something that can handle the heat, some sort of pan or dish.
Right. Metal, glass. You know, nothing plastic. So basically, you want to make sure that your grill runs at 400 to 425 degrees. If it drops down to 350, it's okay.
Okay.
This should take about an hour and a half, 90 minutes or so.
See,
you want a
nice,
beautiful
color.
Mahogany color.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Smell that.
It smells unbelievable.
It is. It's incredible.
See how some of the herbs actually popped out of the can?
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's the kind of pressure that can give. So if you had that full, it might actually fly.
But, wow.
So we're going to let that rest for a second and talk about what we're going to have with it.
Oh, yeah, my gosh.
Absolutely.
It smells wonderful, and you get that nice crispy skin, so you're going to want, you're going to want something that pairs
well. Well,
really
listen, I've got one of my favorite wines for the summer. It is from New Zealand. It is Scarborough Sauvignon Blanc. Now, I know everybody's watching this going, it's beach week. Hey, I saw the wine you have from Scarborough. It looks good. No, Scarborough. A little bit of acid, citrus flavors.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely is good. We
perfect,
just put citrus
Michaela.
Flavors in there.
And what I love about this for the summer, and you can find it anywhere, not just Chris Gasparo's, but anywhere. $11 a bottle.
Wow.
Oh, that's pretty good.
And it's beautiful. It's refreshing because that little bit of acid in it gives it a little kick.
Mm-hmm.
And when you have all of these wonderful spices and all, you need something that's not paper thin.
Yes.
You want something that'll react well with it on your palate. And this is just fabulous. So, Scarborough. Not Scarborough.
It looks the part too. It's in the little sea star right on front there.
Look for the starfish.
And did you notice it's a screw top?
Absolutely, very modern. And what this
does.
One less thing to pack, and you don't have to worry about the wine, getting skunked.
Absolutely. And if you're going to a party or something, you bring this, everyone's going to love you.
They are going to love you. It's a beautiful label. Anyway, it's a beautiful summer. Well, tell me about it. And it's just a beautiful summer wine.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
So,
is it sample time? Because
it is.
I'm wondering
and
what's
the
going on.
The two things you're
going
to notice right away is this is white meat. You're not going to believe how moist it is.
It looks it.
And
so juicy.
The skin is so crispy. It's like when you see a pig roast.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh
so sample.
You
want to
go in front of me?
Okay.
Of course. Sure.
Pardon me, Joe. Pardon my
that's
you're
all right.
Using a fork. I'm just taking it with my hand.
It's an aristocrat.
Cool. He's class. Yeah.
He's all class.
No, I'll just fake it.
So are you.
Wow.
Yeah. So, and it's an easy process.
That
as long
so
as you follow
moist.
The safety features of what you have to do for this. It's so easy, and you can impress people.
And put some grilled, fresh summer vegetables on the grill there, of course.
Ooh.
And look at this. Yeah, beautiful, healthy, great.
Yeah. It's so juicy.
Mm.
And so moist.
So you can only imagine what the dock meat is going to be like.
You know what that is?
Whoa, blowing my mind.
That's an explosion of taste, my friend.
Right.
Exactly what that is.
But
well done.
But no
for
real
the beer
explosion.
Can. That's
absolutely
right.
Absolutely not.
Exactly.
Gentlemen, thank
Drain
you very much.
Always
a pleasure. Always good to see you. You can find this recipe and more information on these fine gentlemen at roadshow.com.